to the celebrity share market now, and Saddam back in top form after months in rehab. He thanks the Atkins diet. Sharapova means it's over for Kournikova, Pavlova leg over. Judy Bailey sells her mutt to the Women's Weekly, Hi Dad It's. Trelease Cooper in the running for the Weekly's Most Beautiful Bird contest, Dress Smart. And Mike Peru in his socks made the new idea. Nowadays, there's a course for everything. You can study drug dealing at Auckland University. There's a degree in sheep worrying at Massey. And believe it or not, one woman, I think she's from Wellington, is doing her doctorate in farts that smell eggy. In short, there's money to be made by teaching shit. And what better way than by tricking a group of young hopefuls into believing one day they'll be making heaps of cash by insulting the leader of the UN or by helping a Canadian corporation make even more money to send offshore. So who will be the next Holmes, Campbell or Alice Worsley? We went to the New Zealand Broadcasting School to find out. Tangata whenua call it Otatahi. To Southlanders, it's Christchurch. To the rest of the country, it's simply known as the City Possessed. It gave birth to some of our best broadcasters, like Jim Hopkins, Petra Bagoust and Julie White. And despite getting beaten up by skinheads, the Japs just love it. These are the young guns who will be tomorrow's media movers. They're the barometer of our broadcasting future, and tonight they face the nation in a testing test. Remember these faces, because one day they could be reading your news on TV, or serving your coffee at Esquire, the one that Carlos owns, or maybe even doing PR for McDonald's.
There's been a lot of talk about who's going to replace Paul Holmes. Who do you think would be a good replacement?
That's a toughie, because I don't know if there's Paul Holmes, you can't sort of just replace him, you know?
The name's evaded me. Who replaces him when he's not there?
Susan Wood.
Susan Wood.
Gosh, I don't know if anyone could replace him.
First of all, I don't think you really can replace Paul Holmes.
Cheeky darky. Discuss.
Cheeky darky. Well,
But I don't think it was a very nice thing to say, especially to the head of the UN.
Oh, I think it gets away with quite a bit, eh?
No, I mean, I still have no idea what exactly was going on there.
Which leading broadcaster is also known as that little creep?
Don't know.
It's not Holmes, is it?
I don't know. I think it's a rather mean term.
It's not Oscar Coatley, is it?
It's John Campbell.
Who's your favourite Maori on TV?
I used to like
Akira Mia.
She's
kind of
Maori.
No, she's not. She's Samoan.
I like Nathan from Sports Hour. Can't say his last name.
Rauru.
Yeah, that's the one. I like him.
Name one ginger journalist.
A ginger? Ginger journalist. Linda Clark? She's not really a journalist, is she?
Is Tony Marsh, is she naturally ginger? I'm not sure. Yeah, I think.
Mark Sainsbury, he's a ginger. He's a good ginger journalist.
Enough of these easy questions. Let's see how they handle a curly one.
A prominent male broadcaster who is tidy but certainly not 10 out of 10. Tries to get you into a three-way with a prominent former weather presenter.
You've had a few drinks and decide to give it a go, but you should really go home because you haven't fed the cat for 2 days. And besides, you're not sure if you can perform under the pressure that situation creates. You have another drink and then another, and then find yourself back at the Heritage Hotel with the two famous broadcasters. They go off to the bathroom to freshen up, leaving you under strict instructions not to touch the minibar.
But you're dying for a so you sneakily go into the minibar and scull back a miniature of it comes back up and you have to puke up. In fact, you puke up into your mouth. You go to the sink, but just pop some goldfish in there. What do you do next?
Find a window.
Is there a window in this hotel room?
Is there a window?
I'd open the drawer.
Can't open the window.
Why not?
They've got those locks on them.
I get rid of the fish. Chuck, because you have to. go back and scull another bottle and hopefully it'll be all good.
I grab that cup, scoop the goldfish out, pull the plug, spew, wash it down, fill it back up, put the goldfish back in.
Do I have a handbag?
Yes.
I could be sick in my hand, I guess. If I had to and I was going to be, I mean, when you're going to be sick, you're going to be sick.
To recap, Holmes is irreplaceable, John Campbell is that little creep, that's according to the Prime Minister. April Howes, your father, is of Samoan descent, and one Sainsbury is our top ginger journalist. And that's our show. Coming up next week, New Zealand's greatest radio pranksters, from the 1950s to shock jock shocker Ian Stables, and Ridgeon Ellis in more media dog madness. From all of us here at Eating Media Lunch. At number 88, it's Play School with whale rider star Awari Paratini.
Oh, hello. I'm looking for some small things so that I can start my egg box collection. They have to be small so that they can fit in here, in the spaces where the eggs were. Not having much luck though. See what I can find on these shelves. Oh, I know what. I'll try this toy, see if that fits. Oh, well, it looked quite small, but it's a bit too big for this egg carton. I wonder what else there'll be. Ooh, here's something. Piece of chalk. That's very small. And, oh, yep, that just fits in nicely. What else can I find?
This program was made with funding from New Zealand On Air.